Good evening. This is All India Radio. I'm Valsa Williams and with me is R.S. Raghu with the evening news. The headlines. Process of filing nominations for vice presidential election begins with issuance of notification. Nominations can be filed till the 19th of July. External Affairs Minister Dr. S. Jayashankar to participate in G20 Foreign Ministers meeting at Bali in Indonesia on the 7th and 8th of this month. Raksha Mantri Rajnath Singh invites French aircraft engine maker Safran for a co-developed and co-productive project in line of Make in India, Make for the World. Karnataka Home Minister Araga Gnanendra says fair, honest and transparent investigation done by CID in police sub-inspector recruitment scam alleges Congress making false allegations against government only to gain political mileage. CRPF establishes special free medical camp at Lambar area of Banihal to provide quick Medicare facilities to pilgrims of Sri Amarnath Ji Yatra and security forces. In Women's Hockey World Cup match between India and China in second pool B underway at Amstelveen in the Netherlands. In cricket, Johnny Bairstow and Root smash tons as England wins rescheduled fifth Birmingham Test match against India to level the series 2-2. And in Wimbledon tennis, match between Novak Djokovic and Jannik Sinner underway for singles quarterfinals. The process for filing of nominations for the 16th vice presidential election has begun with the issuance of notification by the Election Commission. Nominations can be filed till the 19th of this month. The vice presidential election will be held on the 6th of August. BJP's presidential candidate Draupadi Murmu arrived in Imphal today evening to meet MPs and MLAs and seek their support for her upcoming election. She was accorded a rousing welcome at the Imphal airport. All MLAs of BJP, including Chief Minister N. Biren Singh, state party officials along with MPs have attended a meeting with Srimati Murmu at a hotel in Imphal. It may be mentioned that Manipur has 60 members in its Manipur Legislative Assembly along with two MPs of BJP. Out of these 60 MLAs, the number of MLAs of the BJP is 32. The NDA presidential candidate, Ms. Draupadi Murmu, will also be visiting Karnataka on the 10th of July to seek support from legislators. The BJP vice president and in charge of Pondicherry, Nirmal Kumar Surana, informed this in Bengaluru today. In Bihar today, Ms. Draupadi Murmu exhorted MPs and MLAs to vote in favour of her candidature in the upcoming elections. Addressing leaders of alliance partners of NDA in Patna, Ms. Murmu assured that she would perform her duties within the limits of the constitution.
मैं भारत की बेटी हूँ इसलिए भारत के सभी सांसद सभी विधायक को मैं आग्रह करना चाहूँगी इस बेटी को एक बार भारत माँ की सेवा करने के लिए मुझे मौका देंगे मैं आप लोगों के सहयोग से संविधान के दायरे में रह करके भारत माँ की सेवा करने के लिए मैं प्रयास करूँगी मैं अपने आप में मुझे तो विश्वास है आपको मैं निराश नहीं करूँगी.
Earlier, Draupadi Murmu also held a meeting with senior JDU leader and Bihar Chief Minister Nitish Kumar. Shiv Sena Lok Sabha MP Rahul Shevle has written to Party Chief Uddhav Thackeray urging him to support the candidature of NDA's presidential nominee, Ms. Draupadi Murmu. He said Ms. Murmu comes from a tribal community and her contribution to the social sector is immense. He also asked his party chief to issue directions to the Sena MPs to vote for Ms. Murmu.
External Affairs Minister Dr. S. Jayashankar will visit Bali in Indonesia on 7th and 8th of this month to participate in the G20 Foreign Ministers meeting. During his visit, Dr. Jayashankar is expected to hold several bilateral meetings with his counterparts from other G20 member states and invited countries. At the G20 Foreign Ministers meeting, participating foreign ministers will deliberate on issues of contemporary relevance such as strengthening multilateralism and current global challenges including food and energy security. The External Affairs Ministry said participation in the meeting will strengthen India's engagement with the G20 member states. As a G20 Troika member, India's role in the upcoming meeting assumes greater importance. Foreign Secretary Vinay Quatra today had a telephonic conversation with Deputy Minister for Political Affairs, Ministry of Foreign Affairs of Iran, Dr. Ali Bagheri Khani. The two sides discussed various elements of bilateral relations, including progress on the Chabahar port. Vinay Quatra underscored India's commitment to strengthen bilateral cooperation with Iran in addressing shared opportunities and challenges. Both sides also discussed international and regional issues, including Afghanistan.
External Affairs Minister Dr. S. Jaishankar has said that in the last 8 years, Prime Minister Narendra Modi always advocated for neighbourhood first policy. Participating at a discussion on Modi at 20 Dreams Meet Delivery in New Delhi today, Dr. Jaishankar said the vision of Modi government is towards development and prosperity of the entire neighbourhood. He said transformation is taking place in every sphere, be it in power, road, tunnels and waterways. Dr. Jaishankar said India has stepped up in assisting Sri Lanka, which is facing an economic crisis.
In the last 8 years, for example, we are both power exporter and importer from Nepal. The same thing with Bangladesh. We are supplying fuel to a lot of our neighbors. You saw Sri Lanka is in difficulties right now. We have stepped forward to assist them. So this whole idea of India actually as a lifting tide, which is able to lift the entire neighborhood, and a lot of it is human.
A high-level delegation of French aircraft engine maker Safran Group, led by its CEO Olivier Andries, called on Raksha Mantri Rajnath Singh in New Delhi today. Safran is one of the leading original equipment manufacturers of advanced aircraft engines for civil and fighter jets. During the meeting, the CEO of Safran briefed Raksha Mantri of their company's plans to set up a maintenance, repair and overhaul facility in India. The CEO also briefed Rajnath Singh of their plan to inaugurate Safran Aircraft Engines and Safran Electrical and Power India Private Limited in Hyderabad and Safran HAL Aircraft Engines as a joint venture in Bengaluru. The MRO facility in Hyderabad will produce parts and components for advanced aircraft engines and is expected to create several highly skilled jobs. Raksha Mantri noted the importance India attaches to the strategic partnership with France. He welcomed the new facilities in Hyderabad and Bengaluru. Mr. Singh also invited Safran for more co-development and co-production projects in India, in tune with Make in India, Make for the World and Atmanirbhar Bharat of the Government of India. He said India is a big market and Safran can leverage all the competitive advantages, including the cost advantages and availability of trained manpower. Mr. Singh asserted that both countries can contribute to each other's capability building.
Consumer Affairs Minister Piyush Goyal has said that 45 crore transactions have taken place so far under One Nation, One Ration Card. He said One Nation, One Ration Card is a revolutionary step and unique initiative globally. Under the scheme, beneficiaries can get access to subsidized food grains under public distribution system anywhere in the country. Addressing the National Conference on Food and Nutrition Security in New Delhi, Mr. Goyal said the migrant laborers benefited very significantly from One Nation, One Ration Card.
We now have the entire country on One Nation, One Ration Card. All those scandals we had in the past, all the problems, all the corruption in giving ration card, the different colors of ration card, all of that is now digitized. The thumb is the ration card now. And using the thumb throughout the country, a person can get any amount of his entitlement. Beneficiaries can divide the entitlement in more than two places also. Any number of locations, any number of times. As long as the entitlement is there, which is all computerized.
Minister of State for Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and Dairying, Dr. L. Murugan, has said today that the Union Government is implementing several schemes with an aim to double the income of the farmers. He was addressing a function after laying the foundation for a 2-megawatt solar power plant at the MILMA dairy unit at Edapally in Kochi to be set up at a cost of 11.5 crore rupees. The minister said the solar power project will help save the Edapally dairy 90% of its power consumption and make it the first dairy to be run entirely on solar power. Dr. Murugan announced that 29 mobile veterinary units have been allocated to Kerala as part of the Union Government's initiative to take medical facilities to the doorsteps of the farmers. State Minister for Animal Husbandry J. Chinchurani unveiled a bust of Dr. Varghese Kurian, the founder chairman of the National Dairy Development Board, on the occasion. Dr. Murugan later also addressed the valedictory function of the two-day South Zone training camp organized by the Karshaka Morcha of the BJP at Kottayam.
Kerala Governor Arif Mohammed Khan has sought information about a controversial speech of State Fisheries Minister Saji Cherian, reportedly made at a function in Pathanamthitta district. The minister is reported to have slammed the country's constitution, saying it helped to plunder people and exploit the commoners. Blaming the minister for breach of the constitution, the opposition has demanded his resignation. Opposition leader V.D. Satishan told media that they would resort to the legal part unless and until the chief minister expels Minister Saji Cherian. Karnataka Home Minister Araga Gnanendra has said that fair, honest and transparent investigation is done by the CID to apprehend the culprits behind the police sub-inspector recruitment scam. Addressing media persons in Bengaluru today, he alleged that the Congress is making false allegations against the government only. Is making false allegations against the government only to gain political mileage, ruling out their demand for his resignation. The Home Minister said the scams happened when Congress was in power and no action was taken. He charged the Congress for not taking action then, while the present government has ordered CID inquiry in the scam. The ADGP rank police officer Amrit Paul, who was heading the recruitment division, was suspended yesterday and the charge sheet filed. The CID has so far arrested around 60 persons, including the topper of the PSI exam. The exam results were cancelled in April this year after the government admitted that there is a strong evidence to believe that the examination was rigged. Over 54,200 candidates had appeared for the examination. The Anti-Corruption Bureau of Karnataka conducted simultaneous searches on five places belonging to the Chamarajanagar MLA BZ Zameer Ahmed Khan in Bengaluru today. Five teams of ACB officials carried out searches of the house of Zameer Ahmed Khan, his flat in Silver Oak apartment, his guest house, his office, and at the National Travels Office owned by him. The searches were based on the report on disproportionate assets by the Enforcement Directorate. Reacting to the media in Bengaluru today, Chief Minister Basavaraj Bommai said that the raids were conducted after the High Court directed the police to probe pending cases against the Congress MLA from Chamarajanagar in Bengaluru. He added that the raids were conducted after gathering relevant evidence against the MLA. When asked about MLA supporters staging a protest against the raids today, the Chief Minister termed it as an attempt to obstruct the officials from doing their duty. On the Congress allegations, the Chief Minister said it is political vendetta. He added that it has become habitual for the Congress to defend the corrupt.
A 2018 batch IAS officer and Khunti SDO Syed Riaz Ahmed, accused in sexual harassment case, was today produced before the court. After the court proceedings, the accused sub-divisional officer was sent to jail under judicial custody. A complaint of sexual harassment against Syed Riaz Ahmed has been lodged by a student of IIT at Khunti Women's Police Station. Taking quick action on the complaint, the district police has taken the SDM into custody for questioning. Earlier, medical examination was done by the medical team at Sadar Hospital. Elaborate security arrangements were made in the court premises during the proceedings. Pilgrims visiting the holy cave shrine of Sri Amarnath Ji can now give their feedback to the shrine authorities for improving the facilities. Sri Amarnath Ji Shrine Board has launched pilgrim feedback services. The 43-day long annual yatra commenced from both Pahalgam and Balsal routes on 30th of June. The yatra is scheduled to end on the 11th of August on Raksha Bandhan. Meanwhile, to provide quick Medicare facilities to the pilgrims of Sri Amarnath Ji Yatra and security forces deployed for Yatra, 166th Battalion of CRPF based at Banihal in Ramban district established a special free medical camp at Lambar area of Banihal. The camp at Langar site at Lambar area on Jammu-Srinagar National Highway. About 300 pilgrims approach this CRPF medical camp daily for consultation, where they are provided free medicines also. You are listening to the evening news on All India Radio. A reminder of the headlines before we move on. Process of filing nominations for vice presidential election begins with issuance of notification. Nominations can be filed till 19th of July. External Affairs Minister Dr. S. Jayashankar to participate in G20 Foreign Ministers meeting at Bali in Indonesia on 7th and 8th of this month. Raksha Mantri Rajnath Singh invites French aircraft engine maker Safran for co-developed and co-productive project in line of Make in India, Make for the World. Karnataka Home Minister Araga Gyanendra says fair, honest and transparent investigation done by CID in police sub-inspector recruitment scam alleges Congress making false allegations against government only to gain political mileage. CRPF establishes special free medical camp at Lambar area of Banihal to provide quick Medicare facilities to pilgrims of Sri Amarnath Ji Yatra and security forces. In Women's Hockey World Cup, match between India and China in second Pool B underway at Amstelveen in Netherlands. In cricket, Johnny Bairstow and Root smash tons as England wins rescheduled fifth Birmingham Test match against India to level the series 2-2. And in Wimbledon tennis, match between Novak Djokovic and Jannik Sinner underway for singles quarterfinals. For quick news updates round the clock, follow us on our Twitter handle at AIR News Alerts.
अपने बिजनेस को बढ़ाने के लिए लीजिए आकाशवाणी का सहयोग और दीजिए उसे बुलंदियों के पंख।
आपका बिजनेस लोकल है या राष्ट्रीय, आकाशवाणी देती है उपभोक्ताओं तक पहुंचने का हर विकल्प।
और अब तो आप घर, दफ्तर या दुकान पर बैठे बैठे कर सकते हैं आकाशवाणी के किसी भी केंद्र के लिए विज्ञापनों की बुकिंग।
आकाशवाणी के विभिन्न चैनलों पर विज्ञापन देना सुलभ और सस्ता।
बुकिंग है तो संपर्क करें 870-001-4242 पर।
870-001-4242।
कॉम्पिटिशन्स की अगर आप कर रहे हैं तैयारी तो आपके लिए ऑल इंडिया रेडियो लाया है कार्यक्रम अभ्यास, एक ऐसा कार्यक्रम जिसमें आप पूछते हैं सवाल 9289094044 पर या फिर ईमेल करते हैं abhyas.airnews@gmail.com पर, जिसके जवाब एक्सपर्ट देंगे शनिवार रात 9:30 बजे। इस बार का विषय है ज्योग्राफी यानी कि भूगोल और प्रश्न भेजने की अंतिम तारीख है 6 जुलाई। आपके सवालों का हम कर रहे हैं इंतजार। आपका अभ्यास, हमारा प्रयास।
वेलकम बैक टू द इवनिंग न्यूज। Prime Minister Narendra Modi will inaugurate the Golden Jubilee celebrations of the Agradoot group of newspapers through video conferencing tomorrow. Assam Chief Minister Dr. Himanta Biswa Sarma, who is the chief patron of Agradoot's Golden Jubilee Celebration Committee, will also be present on the occasion. Agradoot was started as an Assamese bi-weekly. It was established by Kanak Sendeka, senior journalist of Assam. In 1995, a daily newspaper, Dainik Agradoot, was started and it has developed as a trusted and influential voice of Assam. Prime Minister Modi will visit Varanasi in Uttar Pradesh on the 7th of this month. During his visit, the Prime Minister will inaugurate and lay the foundation stones of multiple projects worth over 1,800 crore rupees. These development initiatives will help in improving infrastructure in Varanasi. Mr. Modi will visit the International Cooperation and Convention Centre, Rudraksh, where he will inaugurate Akhil Bharatiya Shiksha Samagam on implementation of the National Education Policy. The Prime Minister will also inaugurate Akshay Patra Midday Meal Kitchen at LT College in Varanasi, which has a capacity of cooking midday meals for around 1 lakh students. In the last 8 years, Mr. Modi has put a lot of focus on infrastructure development in Varanasi. This has resulted in the transformation of the landscape of the city and enhanced ease of living for the people.
And now let us listen to our special program, Azadi Ka Safar, highlighting the importance of the day during the freedom struggle.
आजादी का अमृत महोत्सव।
आजादी का सफर विद AIR न्यूज। बर्थ ऑफ अ नेशन। इंडियाज ग्लोरियस फ्रीडम स्ट्रगल इज वन ऑफ द ग्रेटेस्ट स्ट्रगल्स द मॉडर्न वर्ल्ड हैज एवर विटनेस्ड। AIR न्यूज ब्रिंग्स यू अ ग्लिम्स ऑफ दिस स्ट्रगल एवरी डे।
To
Today we remember Buddhu Khan, who hailed from Nashik, Maharashtra. He joined hands with the rebels of his locality and took part in the fighting against the British during the First War of Independence in 1857. He also incited his neighbors to raise their arms to attack the British and overthrow foreign rule.
He was caught by the English East India Company troops in one of their attacks on the rebels in the vicinity of Nashik and charged with sedition and rebellion against the British. He was sentenced to imprisonment for life and transported to the Andaman Islands. Buddhu Khan died there in captivity on the 5th of July 1859.
We also pay tribute to Taradas Mukherjee, who was a resident of Nodia, West Bengal. He was a member of a revolutionary group of Nodia, sentenced on the 24th of May 1930 to 6 months imprisonment in connection with a procession at Krishnanagar. Taradas was subjected to brutal physical and mental torture in jail, because of which he committed suicide at Baripada on the 5th of July 1933. AIR News salutes the son of the soil.
We also remember the martyr Durgamal. Durgamal was a resident of Dharmshala, Himachal Pradesh. He was formerly a Hawaldar in the Gorkha Rifles of the British Indian Army. He joined the Indian National Army in Singapore in 1942 and served in the Gorkha Special Squad as captain. Durgamal crossed the Indo-Burma border into Assam on an intelligence assignment, but was subsequently captured by the British and court-martialed on the 5th of July 1944 for waging war against the king and sentenced to death and hanged in the Delhi District Jail on the 25th of August 1944.
And that brings us to the end of this episode of Azadi Ka Safar with AIR News. See you in the next episode tomorrow.
Sweden and Finland signed the accession protocols at the NATO headquarters today. The signing was held in the presence of Finnish Foreign Minister Pekka Haavisto and Swedish Foreign Minister Ann Linde. A report.
The signing comes days after the trilateral memorandum between Turkey, Finland and Sweden. Turkey had initially opposed the Nordic countries' entry into the group, alleging that the two nations are providing shelter to Kurdish separatists. Turkey lifted its opposition at the trilateral summit in Madrid last week, based on certain conditions. The signing of the accession protocols marks the start of the ratification process. In a statement, NATO Secretary General Jens Stoltenberg terms the signing as historic.
This is an historic day for Finland, for Sweden, for NATO and for Euro-Atlantic security.
The development is significant, coming in the backdrop of the Ukraine conflict. Russia opposes the eastward expansion of NATO and Finland is Russia's neighbor. Mr. Stoltenberg said that NATO's door remains open to European as they face what he termed as the biggest security crisis in decades. Anita Anand, AIR.
On to sports. In the FIH Women's Hockey World Cup at Amstelveen in the Netherlands, the Pool B match between India and China is underway. India are now trailing by 1-0 in the second quarter when reports last came in. Both India and China secured a draw in their respective first Pool B matches. India played out a pulsating 1-1 draw with England, while China also played out a 2-2 draw with New Zealand. In cricket, England defeated India by 7 wickets in the rescheduled fifth test match at Edgbaston and Birmingham today. An unbeaten stand of 269 runs between Joe Root and Johnny Bairstow for the fourth wicket helped the hosts chase down a 378-run target in the fourth innings. In Wimbledon, the singles quarterfinals match between top seed Novak Djokovic and Jannik Sinner of Italy is underway. In another men's singles match, Belgian David Goffin is competing with Cameron Norrie of Britain.
The Sensex and the Nifty logged marginal losses amid mixed cues from the global share markets. A report from the Business Desk.
The Sensex lost 100 points to end at 53,134, while the Nifty slipped 24 points to settle at 15,811. In the forex market, the rupee weakened 42 paise against the US dollar. The domestic currency closed at 79 rupees and 37 paise against the American unit. Gold prices were down marginally by 20 rupees. The precious metal was trading at 52,100 rupees per 10 gram. Silver prices also dropped 200 rupees to 58,300 rupees per kilogram, and in intraday trade, oil prices dropped more than 1.5%. Brent crude was trading at $111.70 per barrel. Rajesh Lake for AIR News.
India Meteorological Department, IMD, has warned of heavy rain in central India and west coast for the next 5 days. IMD said heavy to very heavy rainfall is very likely over East Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, several areas of Maharashtra, Goa, coastal Karnataka and Kerala.
Now let us have a look at the weather forecast for tomorrow. National capital Delhi is expected to have a generally cloudy sky with moderate rain. Minimum temperature will be around 28 degrees Celsius. Maximum will be 34 degrees. Mumbai will have a generally cloudy sky with heavy rain. Minimum temperature will be 25 degrees. Maximum will be 27. Kolkata will have a partly cloudy sky with one or two spells of rain or thundershowers. Minimum temperature will be around 27 degrees. Maximum will be 34. Chennai will have a partly cloudy sky with possibility of moderate rain or thunderstorm. Minimum temperature will be 26. Maximum 34. Srinagar and Jammu will have thunderstorm with rain. The minimum temperature in Srinagar will be around 20 degrees Celsius, maximum of 30. In Jammu, minimum temperature will be around 25, maximum 32. Muzaffarabad is expected to have a thunderstorm with rain. Minimum temperature will be around 22 degrees, maximum 29. Leh and Gilgit will have a partly cloudy sky. In South, Hyderabad, Bengaluru, Thiruvananthapuram will have a generally cloudy sky with light rain. In the northeast, Guwahati, Imphal, Aizawl, Shillong, Itanagar, Kohima, Gangtok and Agartala will have a partly cloudy sky with one or two spells of rain or thunder showers. And now before we end the bulletin, the headlines once again. Process of filing nominations for vice presidential election begins with issuance of notification. Nominations can be filed till 19th of July. External Affairs Minister Dr. S. Jayashankar to participate in G20 foreign ministers meeting at Bali in Indonesia on 7th and 8th of this month. Raksha Mantri Rajnath Singh invites French aircraft engine maker Safran for co-developed and co-productive project in line of Make in India, Make for the World. Karnataka Home Minister Araga Gyanendra says a fair, honest and transparent investigation done by CID and police sub-inspector recruitment scam alleges Congress making false allegations against government only to gain political mileage. CRPF establishes special free medical camp at Lambar area of Banihal to provide quick Medicare facilities to pilgrims of Sri Amarnath Yatra and security forces. In Women's Hockey World Cup match between India and China in second pool be underway at Amstelveen in the Netherlands. In cricket, Johnny Bairstow and Root smash tons as England wins rescheduled fifth Birmingham Test match against India to level series 2-2. And in Wimbledon tennis match between Novak Djokovic and Jannik Sinner underway for singles quarterfinals. And with that, we end the evening news. Good night.